Thank you, Mr. President. Senator Kruger, I just love you. I love you so much. You know, I like you keeping me 1 hour talking bad about a bill, and at the end say, I'm voting yes. I love you. I love you. Mr. President and ladies and gentlemen, once in a while, I write a column called What You Should Know. My way to inform my constituents and the voters of the voters of New York of what's going on. Today, I wrote one, and I call it based on a Roman Empire old saying. I entitled it today, Caesar's wife should not only be pure, but should also have the appearance of purity. And by voting for this bill, we might be sending an appearance of impurity, because this bill only benefits the rich. It is a multi-million program of rent exemption and abatement for landlords who renovate their buildings. This piece of legislation, ladies and gentlemen, does nothing to protect and strengthen tenant protection. So tenants in the state, in the city of New York will not be protected with this bill. On the contrary, they might be put in danger. It is just a tax benefit to developers producing luxury buildings. This bill, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm so sorry that Liz Kruger voted for it, this bill does nothing to prevent landlords from double dipping. That's a word, a nice word, double dipping. Meaning that a lot of them will be seeking a J51 tax credit from the government, and at the same time will be increasing the tenant's rent based on a major capital improvement. So this bill will allow landlords to get money from the government for the renovation based on the J51, and at the same time will allow landlords to increase tenants' rents based on something called major capital improvement for the same repair, from the same renovation. And this bill will extend 421A tax benefit to the owner of 15 specific plots in Midtown and Downtown Manhattan, which are now being developed as luxury condominium and office buildings, 15 of them. And according to the New York Tenants and Neighbor Coalition, it seems that only 5 specific developer company will benefit from this piece of legislation. Number one, Extel Development Company. Extel Development Company for their billionaire Tower 157. Silverstein Property, the owner of the World Trade Center. Thor Equities, the company behind the controversial Coney Island redevelopment for 516-520 Fifth Avenue. Number four, Steinhardt Management, who wants to develop 2 former stock exchange buildings in Lower Manhattan. Number five, Sharonham Association Incorporated, who plans to build a 30-story glass tower over the site of the original New York Times building. Ladies and gentlemen, this development do nothing to address the New York City ongoing affordable housing crisis. Therefore, to vote for this bill, we might be sending a message, an impure message, that we only working for the landlords and against the tenants and the regular people in New York City. So again, You could read my, what you should know in my website. It's free. You don't have to pay anything. And today I call it Lex Kruger, Caesar's wife not only shall be pure, but shall have the appearance of purity. I'm voting no with all my heart, with all my strength, and I ask all my colleagues to reject the piece of legislation, especially and irony and guided to the rich, not to the poor. Thank you.